Well, good morning, everyone. It's really good to be with you this week. I thought that last week might be all finished when I read the wrong verses, but yeah, we all recover from the mistakes that we make, especially me, who make them all the time. So yeah, it's really good to be with you. We've started a new series on Ephesians, and it's my privilege and honor to be sharing with you today from Ephesians chapter 1, verses 11 through to 14. I'll just pause for a couple of moments to see if anyone else is going to join us. But yeah, really good to be with you. I'm out in the Bethel Woods today. I guess it reminds me of a song. I'm out in the Bethel Woods today. Be sure of a big surprise. I hope there aren't any big surprises that are going to jump on me out in the woods. But yeah, really good that you've been able to join me. Ephesians chapter 1, verses 11 through to 14. In him we were also chosen, having been predestined according to the plan of him who works out everything in conformity with the purpose of his will, in order that we, who were the first to hope in Christ, might be for the praise of his glory. And you also were included in Christ when you heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation. Having believed, you were marked in him with a seal, the promised Holy Spirit, who is a deposit guaranteeing our inheritance until the redemption of those who are God's possession to the praise of his glory. Yeah, welcome everyone. Hi Bex, good to see you. Welcome everyone to today's Daily Thoughts. Ephesians chapter 1, verses 11 through to 14. And when I read this and started to try and understand what it was that Paul was trying to teach the church at Ephesus, there were four particular things that came out to me. And these four things were just two words: in him, in Christ, and in him. If you go through just these few verses in Ephesians, you'll see that Paul constantly is encouraging the church at Ephesus to be rooted in Christ, to be rooted in him, to be established in him, to be firm in him. And that's what I take from this. I know that there's been debates about predestination, Calvinism and Arminianism, and all of these debates, and I've done it all in college, and it just goes on and on and on. But what I really take from this particular passage is those four two words: in him, in Christ, and in him. And wherever you are and wherever you're watching this, I want you to know that if you're saved, if you're a believer in Jesus Christ, you're rooted and you're established in him. And at the end of this particular passage, in verse 13, it says that you were marked in him with a seal of the promised Holy Spirit. You were marked in him, you're marked in him, you're established in him, and you've received the promise of his Holy Spirit. Whatever your circumstances are, whatever you go through every single day, whether you're locked in, locked down, whether you're in the woods, whether you're a pastor, whether you work for the NHS, whether you're going to be walking your dogs today, whatever you're going to be doing, you're marked in him with the promised Holy Spirit. So be encouraged with this daily thought today. Ephesians chapter 1, verses 11 through to 14. Whatever your circumstances, you're firm, you're rooted, you're strong, and you're established.